For the past 20 seasons on the Walmart FLW Tour, one lake has been on the schedule nearly every year. It's not an easy lake to fish and can wreck the hopes for Angler of the Year or worse, put an angler on the bubble for making the Forestwood Cup.
This lake has really been a thorn in my side. I mean, I've had a lot of bad tournaments here. A couple of good ones, but a lot of bad ones in the 13 or 14 years I've been coming here. God!
But there are a few anglers who have figured out how to catch limits consistently, and two anglers who have flourished here in the past 3 years, Andy Morgan and Matt Airy. Once again, these two find themselves in contention on the final day.
Go around.
And they are chasing after Scott Canterbury, who has come within ounces of winning several times in the past two seasons. Will Canterbury finally seal the deal on a tour victory, or will he once again fall short by the slimmest of margins? FLW starts now.
Here we go, boys and girls. First cast, fluke stick.
15, 16, 17, 18 pounds, 5 ounces.
When the FLW Tour pros look at the schedule, Beaver Lake is often the biggest question mark in their mind. This lake never fishes the same way twice, and for many in the field of 160-plus anglers, this lake is the hurdle between them and valuable season points in their quest to qualify for the Forestwood Cup.
The Forestwood Cup is the Super Bowl of bass fishing, the World Championship, and we want to make that every year.
That's what we're talking about, boys!
But over the past few years, this fishery has begun to thrive, and the bass it produces have become larger in size. And anglers are starting to look forward to a springtime throwdown on Beaver Lake.
Fish number one. Good job, man. Junior. That's the way we do it.
Located among the Ozark Hills of Northwest Arkansas, Beaver Lake is an impoundment of the White River. In a typical year, the water clarity will vary from deep, clear water down near the dam to muddier water up the river. Anglers will take off from Prairie Creek Marina, and while most fisheries have known hotspots for finding bass, Beaver Lake is known as a pattern lake.
Beaver Lake this week is better than I've ever seen it. This is probably my seventh or eighth time here. And because of the stained water, they had a lot of high water over the winter. And because of the stained water, the fish have just been biting.
It's a real conditional fishery as far as the weather goes, and it's a weather-driven bite. A lot of times where you caught one means nothing to where you're going to catch one in the tournament or where you caught one the day before. It's always a new day. The sun comes up, and you've got to go do something different.
You have a section of the middle part of the lake that is stained water. And up by the dam, it's crystal clear. And then way up the river, where it's usually stained, is back to clear again. So it's kind of a strange dynamic. The fish are spawning quite a bit from mid-lake up to the dam, and they're not spawning a lot down the river.
Over the first 2 days, Beaver Lake produced some big stringers as JT Kenny, who has struggled here for years, led the tournament on day one.
18 pounds, 5 ounces.
But as is so often the case, day two was a bit more challenging.
They shrunk for sure. They weighed 9 pounds, 6 ounces, JT.
The warming trend and increased wind shifted the bass around a bit more. Pros like Matt Airy and Andy Morgan took advantage of their opportunities and jumped into the weekend cut. And now they join 18 other pros looking to survive and make it to the fourth and final day.
You know, they're changing a little bit. I'm going to have to be changing a little bit because they're changing. I've been catching about 15 keepers in this one place, and maybe I caught them all, but they're doing something different because I still seen a lot of fish in there, but they just wouldn't bite. So I'm going to have to move. I'm going to have to do something different.
Anybody that wins on Beaver Lake's got to beat Andy Morgan. Then you got Mr. Beaver Lake, Matt Airy, who you know telling he's liable to come in with a monster bag. So all I can do is go fish the best of my ability, keep it wet, and try to catch, you know, you want to catch one of those big bags. I caught that big bag on day two.
18 pounds, 3 ounces right there, man.
If you can make it to day four and catch another big bag, anybody can win on Beaver Lake. Whoever catches the biggest bag on day four is going to win this tournament. They're going to bite today.
Canterbury and Robertson both understand that the fishing is getting better every day and that nothing less than a mid-teen limit will make them feel secure about making the top 10 cut. Matt Airy has won here 2 years in a row, and he is feeling the pressure as well as the chance to make history. And three-peat is becoming a constant question for him.
Yeah, if I had a dollar for every time somebody asked me if I was going to three-peat, I wouldn't have to fish this event. So I'd make enough money just off that. But yeah, I mean, I did put a lot of pressure on myself. You know, when you win an event, that's all you want to do. You know, I mean, there's no feeling like that in the world. And when you win back-to-back and you get an opportunity like this, it just doesn't come around very often. Yeah, that's all I thought about all week was three-peat.
That's kind of what I figured. They're moving towards the back.
I don't know that I've been in the top 10 here at Beaver Lake in a long time, that Matt Airy hadn't been in the top 10 and pretty much won the tournament. So it would be really nice if he didn't make the top 10 this time. But I'm sure he's going to. So with that being said, I just like to win and finally beat Matt Airy at Beaver Lake once. I won here in 2007, but he wasn't fishing then. So I don't guess that counts. I'm fishing a crankbait, pretty shallow. I'm grinding the bill off crankbait. I've been through three crankbaits this week. I'm talking about rounding the bills down to where they don't even run right anymore. You know, fishing it real shallow, those fish are staging right on that. There's a ledge there where it comes out, and those females are kind of hanging out right around that lip for me. So I'm just grinding it as many casts as I can get going down the bank is what I'm doing.
Oh my goodness, Jeff. Oh, typical Jeff Sprague fashion. Outside the net.
Oh, Beaver Lake. I didn't even think bass like this lived in Beaver Lake.
It ain't been long ago that I had two ounces cost me $440,000 in the Forestwood Cup, so I know how big it can be. I'll take everything I get. There's a good one. Oh, yeah. 3 pounder. Choked the Canterbury craw. That's Beaver Lake right there.
Scott Canterbury's prediction that the fish would bite today is coming true. And not just for him, all over the lake. The shallow springtime bite has turned on and anglers are boating quality bass. With only 20 boats on the water, there's less pressure on the fish. This tournament just got kicked into high gear. Scott Martin has a word for the size of the fish he's been catching today.
God, yes, dude. Donkeys. Donkeys, dude.
I'm kind of in trouble. For me, it's been tough. I haven't been getting the bites of what I needed to, you know, even stay in there. I think I've got 3.5 pound lead on 10th place. I got to get something where I won't stay there, you know. I got 9 pounds. Maybe. Maybe. The weights are going to be tight. When this thing's all over, it's probably going to be ounces to determine the winner. Everybody's catching the same fish. They're doing the same thing. Well, the first day, I had a 4 pounder bit me like the last 30 minutes. And about 1 o'clock yesterday, I was kind of grim, you know, because I had about 9 pound stringer. And I caught a fish that weighed about 5.5 pounds and one weighed about 4.5 pounds. And all of a sudden, I'm smart, you know, because it takes you way down there to, you know, to the top. We'll fish tomorrow. That ought to give me about 11 pounds or so. Woo, son, I'm happy.
Daryl Robertson stays in the conversation with that kicker bite as the competitors start making their way back to the Walmart in Rogers, Arkansas for the weigh-in. There was another fishing derby going on today. And while no cash prizes were being handed out, the rewards may be even greater.
It is the FLW Unified Fishing Derby is what it is. It's a partnership between the FLW Foundation and myself. And I work closely with the Special Olympics of Arkansas. And we're out here getting kids and Special Olympics athletes out on the water fishing.
She's caught 6 so far in an hour and a half. Pull up.
Just catching the first fish, it can turn a kid on to fishing for a lifetime. But the neat thing about it is, kids getting out here, they get an appreciation for the outdoors. So even if they don't fish full time, they care more about the outdoors, they're going to take care of the lakes, it's going to make better fishing and better outdoors for all of us.
Special Olympics, they have all kinds of different programs and games. We realized that there was no fishing. There was no connection with fishing and Special Olympics. Being an FLW angler, you know, that's where my passion is, along with Special Olympics, and so we decided to merge the two.
She caught one, and like they say, any day is a good day to go fishing.
We call it a unified fishing derby. You know, getting some of the kids out here with some of the intellectually disabled individuals, you know, and realize that they're just another person out here fishing with them. And that's the great thing about fishing. It doesn't matter if you even speak the same language as the person. You can go out and truly enjoy what you're doing. And so to get to bring everyone in the community together to see that, it is really, really great.
A truly special event that Cody and his wife Savannah have put together. The winners receive a trophy for biggest fish and most fish caught. And they even get a chance to meet the legendary Forrest L. Wood.
Arguably the greatest angler in the history of the sport, Andy Morgan. 16 pounds and 13 ounces. Back-to-back cuts. You're having a great year, Darrell Robertson. 13 pounds and 1 ounce. You're in second place, Scott Canterbury. Hammerberry, 14 pounds and 6 ounces. Scott Canterbury, you got the lead.
As we head into the final day, these weights are stacked as tight as can be. Scott Canterbury has just over a 1 pound lead, but the way this lake is fishing right now, it can hardly be called a comfortable margin. Only 10 men left to fish on the fourth and final day of the Walmart FLW Tour on Beaver Lake.
The Walmart FLW Tour is brought to you by Costa Del Mar. See what's out there. Minn Kota, anywhere, anytime. BRP Evinrude, learn more at evinrude.com. General Tire, anywhere is possible. You can get more from your oil with Quaker State. And by Ranger Boats, still building legends, one at a time.
The skies brighten here on Championship Sunday as the final day of the Walmart FLW Tour on Beaver Lake is set to begin. This event, presented by Jack Links, has all the makings of a barn burner as conditions have improved every day.
First thing this morning, we got a little wind, a little bit of cloud. I'm probably going to crank a little bit this morning, and then as the sun gets on up and some of these fish commit a little bit more to the bank, to the bed, I'll probably go ahead and slow down and fish a little bit slower.
I'm going to be fishing more of a pattern today. If that fails, I'll go back to how I made the first cut on. But I think with the wind blowing the cloud cover, I've got to change up. I don't want to win this thing. I'll throw a jig all day long.
Going in the final day, I've got a small lead over 10th place. I'm just a small lead over second. So I'm not going to change what I'm doing. I'm just fishing whatever looks good in front of me. I fished a little bit different every day and a little bit of new water every day, and I'm just going to keep trying to do that and give it my all and just see how it ends up.
Scott is hoping that at the end of the final day, the leaderboard reads the same way it does right now, with him at the top. Matt Airy and Andy Morgan, two anglers that have finished 1 and 2 here the last 2 years, are once again in the hunt. It'll all come down to finding that key big bite.
Slipped back in here past the no-wake zone. I didn't tell anybody this yesterday, but I came in here and I had 19 minutes when I came through the idle zone yesterday. I ran back and pulled in on a little place, got started. The last 7 minutes of the day, I culled 3 times. I caught a 5 and 2 threes. Ran back in, I had 1 minute left. Made my day go from 11 to 16, 13. Great decision.
As good as I thought it was. we'll can't take them though. We're still gonna have to catch them better than that. Jig biter.
Buddy's on fire coming out of there.
We'll take him.
I'm about 20-something miles up the river, flipping this 45-degree angle bank right here. It's got a lot of chunk rock and laydowns on it. I think my best chance at a mega bag is fishing stuff like this. The water's dropping on this lake right now, and what's happening is a lot of these fish that are normally way back in the bushes, back in the flats, they're staying on these steeper banks on the little bit of cover that's down there. Kind of a pre-spawn deal. Some of the fish I caught here yesterday were really nice and fat. That's a good one. That's a real good one. Thank you, Lord. It's a good plant right here, boys. This could get really interesting. I left these fish biting yesterday. We had a warm night last night. My plan is that these fish are still doing what they did yesterday when I was coming in. That's awesome right there. Good deal.
Oh, this water where I'm fishing is not 18 inches deep. That little scrub buck brush is in a little bit deeper water. That buck brush is just about maybe 15 inches deep or 18. Well, I kind of changed my pattern up because I think, you know, down the lake in that clear water, what I was doing, it played out, you know. So we had the right kind of conditions, fish real shallow. And so that's what I'm gonna do all day long. Trying to get in there where I can dangle it around the root system. If they're spawning, they'll be close to that root system. A lot of times if you'll drop it in there right there on them, they'll just they'll react, you know.
Gosh.
That's about a 4-pounder.
You know, it's really cool to be on Beaver Lake and doing well this week because this lake has really been a thorn in my side. I mean, I've had a lot of bad tournaments here. Couple of good ones, but a lot of bad ones in the 13 or 14 years I've been coming here. It feels good, you know. I feel like I beat the beaver a little bit. And I noticed at the beginning of the event, I was catching them on a crankbait, kind of towards the fronts of the pockets. And then as the event wore on, they kind of moved to about halfway back in the pockets, or maybe even 2/3 of the way back in the pockets. You know, I'm pretty sure they were spawning because they were almost all the way to the back and they kind of held there. They never went all the way to the back. They kind of held on, you know, kind of bluffy, kind of vertical rock, like right at the end of vertical rock going back into a pocket.
There's still some females moving in here. These males are all getting on beds. We can't see them, this water's dirty. There's some chunkier rock out there on the bottom that you can't see. Gets a little bit of a steeper drop where she can sit right up. And I'm just ticking along. Just pop the rocks just right and get that reaction off of her. There's a big one. Oh my goodness. That's a big one. Oh, watch out, watch out. Oh. Oh. Come here, baby, stay down. Stay down, sweetheart. Stay down, baby. Just come here, baby. Oh, come here. Come here, honey.
Woo! Woo!
That's a Beaver Lake bass right there, brother.
Woo!
Oh, my goodness.
I know they're gonna be biting. You know, I mean, I'm just gonna go out and fish hard as I can, leave it all out there, catch everything I can catch, and hopefully make them beat me, you know. As long as I don't beat myself, I think everything will work out.
Get in here. Boom!
Number one. First time I've been in here all week. They're wanting to spawn. They're getting ready to spawn. I mean, they're just moving up. Every day, there's something moving up.
2.5 pounds.
So Jeff Sprague has jumped ahead with the dramatic catch that sent him running to the back of the boat. But we are just getting things started here on the final day. It's the Walmart FLW Tour, and anything can happen. Don't go away.
That we're in trouble.
long time to fish.
I don't know if he's 15 or not. Probably not. They're biting, and that's all that matters.
Fish are acting up everywhere, and I can't get a bite on them.
Springtime in the Ozark Mountains, and all kinds of fish are biting. But these anglers are after the best 5 bass they can cross hairs on.
I seen another fish chase back in there. I'm going to circle around, and I'll go back down that bank. It'll take a little more time than what we took then.
Daryl Robertson hasn't gone very far from the launch at Prairie Creek Marina. The creek harbor has become one of the more dependable pieces of water for tournament anglers over the years, usually just to get a limit. Daryl found a much better bite this morning when he lost a 4-pounder, but he's gone right back to work though, and this bass here is going to put him in the plus column for the day.
I couldn't have done it been hooked like that. I'd trade him for that other one. I'll take him.
Fishing Beaver Lake as many years as I have has made me a better fisherman because this lake here patterns really well. Literally, I catch fish every day on different lures, different techniques. Once you figure it out, you can run that pattern all over the lake and it works. So again, this lake here has made me a better fisherman.
Yes, that's a keeper. You know the deal about this spot here, it's not the spot that's good. It's actually the pattern. You know, this is a good area, but there's a lot of new water that we're gonna fish today. And if I keep catching fish like this and bigger, I've got a shot at this thing. Good night. I mean, this is crazy.
They're not keepers. I just seen 3 of them right there together. That's ridiculous. I mean, that's the kind of stuff that you're supposed to win with. There's like a school of 30 of them. I ain't seen nothing like that all week. And I can't get a bite. That's the bad thing.
That's a big one. Get in here!
That's what we're here for.
That's a 4-pounder.
Got 3 more to go, and it's over.
Canterbury is he's one of the greats, and he's been really close several times. His time's coming. Now, whether it's this weekend is yet to be determined, but consistency wins tournaments at Beaver Lake. You have to average in that 14, typically it's been 14 in the past, it'll be a little higher this year. You know, I said before this event coming in, I thought, you know, shooting for the 60-pound mark, 60 pounds I could see winning this event for sure. There again, it's all about who catches them the last day, but yeah, you have to be consistent throughout the event.
Matt Airy expecting an easy boat flip, but he never got the head turned, and that fish was upside down when he went for the pull, allowing the hook to come out. And with the miss, his chances of a three-peat become that much harder.
It's a really fine line on where this crankbait has to be to get those fish to bite. They're not holding on that shelf that's truly where they want to spawn. There's an additional drop out here in that probably 4-foot range. And that's pretty much what I'm targeting, I'm trying to hit. And the percentages of trying to keep a crankbait in that zone, and to me, are small. But if we can just make as many casts as we can in a day to keep it there and get it around as many bass as we can, then another one.
That's a good one. Oh, it's a good one. Oh, stay down. Stay down.
Oh. I won't turn my nose up at those either.
It's coming. I mean, I believe I'll get a good bite or two. It's, you know, you just hope you land them when you get them. Stay focused, stay ready. That's all you can do. We're just improving our odds. Every 5 minutes we don't catch one. Every second we don't catch one. Keeper. Still not what we're looking for, but a keeper.
Andy Morgan closing in on Scott Canterbury, once again proving he has got this lake figured out. But can he finally break through and seal the deal? The Walmart FLW Tour continues after these messages.
2 pounds.
Oh, there he is. That's a good one, dude.
Salt flicker.
Oh my gosh, getting red.
It's the kind we're looking for on Beaver Lake.
So much action on this final day. Let's get you caught up quickly. Scott Canterbury now has over 55 pounds without landing a fifth keeper, while Andy Morgan also has 4 in the box, but has slid down the leaderboard because none of them are in the 4-pound class range.
Good conditions to catch one. Don't get any better. There's a lot of fish that actually spawn in this area. Good flat pocket, wind blowing on it. Got some history of being a good area. It should be a good area today. In the morning felt good. The conditions were there. The wind was already blowing. The clouds were moving. There's a storm coming in. It's one of those mornings, if you're a springtime bass fisherman, that you live for. You know it's gonna happen. You know they're gonna bite. They're pulling up to spawn. It's the bass rut, I call it. It's the days in the spring that you wanna be out there. Windy, kind of, you know, just changing during the spawn. That's when you wanna be there. Just trying to put one bite together. I mean, you know, one bite could definitely win this deal. Came through the little sticks, the weeds, in the lockdown. Stops. You know when it stops and it locks down. You didn't see the flash. It didn't streak from the side and push it to the side. It just locked it down. You know that fish has ate that spinnerbait. And I see it kind of coming through the water and I'm thinking, dip net. It's going through my head, dip net. It's coming, it's coming. It's a 6-pound fish. And I'm almost to that point, if I make it through this jump, that I'm going for the net, because I'm gonna make it through the jump and I'm gonna stop it, then I'm gonna bring it to me and I'm gonna net it. I didn't make it through the jump. Way it went. And probably at that point, so did my chances. But early enough in the day, you still can make that up. Get the bite I need, jumps, comes off. I'm not lost a bass in 3 days. Finally, I lose one, and it is the one that you need to catch.
Things could change quick here. I have 4 keepers, but it boils down to setting the hook just a couple of times on those good fish. 2 or 3 good fish will win this tournament.
Today, these fish busted loose, and here's why. It was warm yesterday, and it was warm last night, so the water temperatures didn't fall at all. We have overcast conditions, and it's super windy in the spring. Those fish, this is the best day that they have had to get out, roam around, and feed, and they took advantage of it.
Oh my gosh, dude. Yes! Woo! Now we're cooking.
That's what Beaver Lake is all about. You just gotta fish the conditions, get a pattern going, and just go with it. It's a nice fish right there. I need 5 like that to win this thing.
The fish I'm catching now are spawning. The fish I was catching the first day are pre-spawn, but the fish I'm catching now are spawning. I mean, they spawn in the wind, but it's hard to catch them when you're in the blowing in the wind. And they're just more active if it's just a little bit protected. I mean, the wind's blowing in there regardless because we're in the hills, but I try to stay out of that direct force of the wind.
Get in here.
I ain't never caught a bass in this pocket in my life. 2.5. Number 5.
That, give it. Gosh, dang it. And you can't win a tournament doing what I just did right there. That bull that come out of there, I think that fish is probably a 4 or 5 pounder. I should be having 15 or 16 pounds right now. Instead, I've got 4 fish that weighs 10. I just haven't had a real good day. Can you believe that? Crap. That's just all I can stand to that one.
So Daryl decides that one rod must have been cursed, and now he knows he will never lose another bite on that piece of graphite again. And he's not out of this one yet. As the final day of the Walmart FLW Tour on Beaver Lake unfolds, there's plenty of time for someone to catch. Quaker State Pro Scott Canterbury. Stay tuned.
Ounces at a time.
I think it's that same 4-pounder.
Not a Beaver Lake giant, but we'll hopefully get rid of that guy.
That 3-pounder?
Pretty good trade.
Yeah! I love it! That's how you fish Beaver Lake, I'm just telling you.
They are spread out all over this beautiful lake in the northwest corner of Arkansas. The professional anglers on the Walmart FLW Tour are running patterns, finding fish in new water using a variety of methods. Jeff Sprague is down toward the dam and has been on fire with his crankbait today, while the leader, Scott Canterbury, is pitching jigs in the backs of creek arms up the White River. Daryl Robertson also pitching a jig, but he has had trouble converting bites into keepers.
How can you miss the same 4-pounder two different times in one day? I kind of figured out these fish were real, real shallow. The new growth buck brush was standing about probably 15 inches of water, and that's where I figured out to get the bites, and I probably had 10, 15 bites in that water about 15 inches deep. I saw a brown jig, and it was Uncle Josh meat on it. It used to be like the old pork.
Get in there.
One more bite like that, and I'll win this thing. Dadgummit, I'm going to catch him yet, though. In spite of myself. I done good getting rid of that rod logo, didn't I?
Quaker State pro Scott Canterbury has topped the 60-pound mark to hold on to the lead. There was a time on Beaver Lake when 45 pounds over 4 days would guarantee victory. But times have changed, and right now, Daryl Robertson and Jeff Sprague are keeping up with the pace.
Feeling really good, you know, and just keep working my way around that pocket. When I come back out the other side, and it's, you know, still looking like the same kind of stuff. Same thing, I pitched that Nichols jig up to the bluff. You know, there was a little crack in the bluff. And then the line just started swimming off. And when I set the hook on that one, I knew, I was like, man, it's another big one, you know. You know, most of the guys that are on them are catching 14 or 15 pounds a day. So, you know, knowing that you have to do that, it's interesting. And dude, when I flopped that one in the boat, I knew that, you know, I just made a whole bunch of money right there. You know, didn't know if I was gonna win or not, but just like I said, every place is thousands of dollars. You know, when you start getting in the top, you know, sixth, fifth, fourth, every place is thousands of dollars.
These fish are moving around. I know they're moving around. They're getting up close to these banks that they spawn on. Got some wind on them, and they're biting. Only thing that concerns me, we're not catching any good ones. We're just catching fish. Just a bunch of males is all we're catching. That's not gonna get me any bigger piece of the pie. In 2007, I actually won this tournament. Caught the majority of them out of these two pockets right here. I'm fixing to go around. There's one right there and a good one. As I was saying, 2007, this was a good pocket. Looks like in 2016 it is too. No giant, but he's better than what we got.
Beaver's muddy. We've got, obviously, it was muddy up the river all the way down to Mid Lake, and I really enjoyed Beaver being that way. I felt like there were the fish that came from out suspended, and they moved to the banks, and they were position themselves where I could catch them. So it really fell into my wheelhouse and the way I like to fish. So I just picking it apart piece by piece.
Oh, it's a good one. Oh, it's a good one. Stay on there, baby. You're cool. Oh, come here. Oh, it ain't a giant, but hey, it's 15. Yes, sir, that's a 16-inch Beaver Lake bass, and we're proud to have it.
There's not a lot of water in the bushes, so windy points right now are really good. Anytime on Beaver Lake, you got a lot of wind like this, just run windy banks that have some depth to it, a little bit of cover, whether it's rock or wood, and you're gonna catch some fish. I'll pull it in my second primary area.
Oh, there's one.
Oh, it's a big one, too.
Yes, yes, yes. Smallmouth, baby. Choking chatterbaits. How about that? I pulled in my second area here. See Annie Morgan's up on the other side. This is where I caught some good fish yesterday. That's a good one there. He left one for me, Andy. Thank you. Nice.
The most important factor now is time, as there's only a little left for this Walmart FLW Tour event presented by Jack Links. Will Scott Canterbury finally win his first tour-level event, after coming so close in the past 2 years? We'll find out when we return.
The Walmart FLW Tour is brought to you by Find, Navigate, Dominate with Lowrance HDS and Structure Scan 3D. Mercury Marine, number one on the water. GoPro, this is your life, be a hero. Power Pole, swift, silent, secure. Motor Guide, trolling motors engineered for top anglers. And by Walmart, save money, live better.
I feel like I'm getting closer to what I need. That and a help.
Yeah, he'll help.
Woo! Nicole.
I'm sure he's 15. I don't think he helps me.
A little bit of an upgrade, not much.
It has been nonstop all day here on Beaver Lake. Whether it's first place Scott Canterbury or 10th place Andrew Upshaw, the bite has been tremendous. But only one trophy is given and little time left for anyone to make a run for it.
This old tournament's kind of a one-day tournament right now. There's about five or six guys that's just within about a pound of each other. I'd catch another one in 4.5 pounders right now. I'd start feeling really good. I really feel like I'd have a shot to win. If I could cull a fish, it'd help me a pound. I'd feel like I had a really good shot. He's dang near a 3 pounder, isn't he? Got a bad problem, have to call 3 pounders.
You know, Darryl's really, when he's dialed in on something, he's really strong. And he's been catching them this week doing something different. And then yesterday evening, right before weigh-in, he really figured them out. And I mean, he's gonna be hard to beat for sure. I mean, there's no doubt about it. I mean, you know, but if I got a pound over him, so if I catch 15, I'll have a shot, you know. But if I can catch 16, I think I'm gonna be hard to beat.
There he is. That's one.
It's a solid fish, yeah. Solid. 3 pounder.
When the wind blows and the clouds roll in on Beaver, these fish, they eat. I mean, it's unbelievable. The wind blew, it got cloudy, and I sort of started just fishing the conditions. I just kind of ran and looked around and saw what all I thought would be a player, and it started just picking apart piece by piece. I feel really good about what's going on. I've had a great run, you know, in the last few tournaments, and that's always a good confidence boost when you go to the next event. You come in from an event, you're coming off a good event. I just came from Grand, where I actually only caught 9 pounds the first day, and then wound up backing that with 18 pounds the second day and moved from like 75th to like a top 25. So, you know, you have to just maintain focus and bear down and just and go with your gut. And I've been doing that, and it's been working well for me, and we'll just ride it. We'll ride it as long as we can.
Look at there, come off in the net.
Yes, sir.
Just took a little time.
We got about as much time as I had yesterday when I caught 2 big ones. I need 2 fives, dude. I get 2 fives. I got a shot at this thing. So let's get it done.
I made a bad cast, and my chatterbait was coming out of the water, and he came up and ate it at the surface. So I literally just set the hook, and there was no way out of the tree. I had the fish suspended in the midair.
Oh, mighty, that was crazy.
That was the craziest fish fight I've ever seen in my life.
I don't know for sure how much I got. I think the 4 little ones weigh right at 3 apiece, I think. Get up there. Thank you, Lord. You gotta catch 60 pounds on Beaver in 4 days. You are to win if you don't win. It's a 4 pounder, ain't he? I sure feel like I got a shot at winning it now.
Worst we can do is 10th. Hold on, we got a minute.
It's the Walmart FLW Tour on Beaver Lake presented by Jack Links, and this barn burner has turned into a nail biter as time on the water has ended.
There's some really good sticks in this top 10, so, and with the weather conditions today and the slim margin with the lead, this is anybody's game.
Caught some fish, caught a lot of fish. Not disappointed in that, but never had but that one good bite, which is very disappointing, but that's part of it.
You got some of the best in the world behind me, so I don't know, we'll just have to put them on the scales and see where it all falls.
A 5-bass limit today for Andrew Upshaw. Worth 10 pounds and 9 ounces. You're the new leader. On day one, he weighed in 18 pounds and 5 ounces. JT Kenny, 5 today. Worth 16 pounds, 15 ounces. You're the new leader. That's the play lock. 10 pounds even. Matt Airy, a 5-bass limit. 12 pounds and 15 ounces. Moves you into second place. Chris Whitson, 10 pounds and 4 ounces. Chris is the reigning angler of the year. He is a former Forestwood Cup champion. Scott Martin, limit of bass. Worth 16 pounds and 3 ounces. You're the new king of the hill. He's got more top tens than anybody. Andy Morgan, let's go. 13 pounds, 13 ounces. Moves you to third place.
There's a big one.
Woo! That's a Beaver Lake bass right there, brother.
Woo-hoo-hoo!
Beaver Lake studs, unbelievable.
He was catching them early and often this morning. He's got 44 pounds coming into this final day. Jeff Sprague, wow! 5 today, worth new leader. 16 pounds, 13 ounces, you got it, wow!
Get in there. One more bite like that and I'll win this thing. I sure feel like I got a shot at winning it now.
One of the legends of this sport, a guy who's a former Forestwood Cup champion, a guy who's approaching the $2 million mark, Daryl Robertson. You're gonna need 16 pounds and 10 ounces. 17 pounds and 1 ounce. You've got the lead.
Get in here!
This guy's approaching the $1 million mark with FLW. He's a former Rookie of the Year. He has 13 top 10s. 7 times the Forestwood Cup where he has finished 2nd there. In 3 days, he's weighed more than anybody coming into this final day with 45 pounds and 7 ounces. Let's hear it for Scott Canterbury. Wow! Only $125,000 on the line. Scott Canterbury, you need 15 pounds and 13 ounces. 15-13 for your first tour victory. Let's get the monkey off the back. Let's go, here we go. 5 today for Scott Canterbury. Worth 17 pounds even. Your champion is Scott Canterbury. Wow! $125,000 richer. You joined the ranks of a tour champion.
Man, that's awesome. That's what I always wanted, I mean, since I started this. I mean, the money's great, but that trophy I'll always have. I'll spend the money, but that trophy I'll always have it. I'm like, yeah, it's forever. I caught 19 of the 20 on a jig, and I either had 15, 20, or 25-pound P-line fluorocarbon on. Caught one of them off the bed that I seen, and I caught it on a little pocket crawl from net bait, and I caught it on 65-pound braid. I don't use light line.
Scott Canterbury, $125,000, and now a tour champion.
Scott is certainly one of the toughest sticks in this sport, and he now gets to be known as a tour champion. Congratulations to him and to all of our competitors who really put on a fantastic show this week. For the greatest coverage of professional bass fishing, you know you can always turn to FLW.